激动的啦啦队，卖旗帜的小贩，让北京工人体育场一早就充满亢奋的心情。亚洲杯中日决赛晚间即将开打，不过一早这里就挤满球迷，抗日情绪升高到最高点。这里是北京的工人体育馆，在大战的前夕呢，已经有相当多的球迷在这边聚集。由于这场球赛已经变成了所谓的两国之争，所以看得出来现在球迷在现场的情绪都非常的高涨，
也是抗日，也是激励中国的球队，
抗日英雄，
解放军，爱国，
爱国感呀，多荣。
像1960年代的青年一样。
除了有穿军装来加油的球迷之外，还有人远从辽宁要来替爷爷报仇，理由是因为他爷爷死于抗日战争。
抗日战争时期，
对啊，牺牲的这些人都是我们爷爷辈的，所以说我们想到是替我爷爷报仇。
连替爷爷报仇的人都来凑热闹。除此之外，还有不少球迷是因为买不到票，所以才到现场抗议。
我们外地球迷吧，这么长时间坚守在这里，没有一张票，得不到一张票。找票务中心推到我们到中体，中体又推到我们到票务中心，票务中心又推我们到组委会，全部跑掉了。
他们要拼什么，我们实在搞不清楚。不过这些激情俨然成为不定时炸弹，因此大陆公安晚间至少派出10000名警力维持秩序，武警更是一早就进驻现场。球赛还没开打，现场已经弥漫一股抗日战争的情绪。TVBS 新闻，谢谢蒋昭，北京采访报道。
镜头转到台湾来，关心的是现场消息。台北县板桥甘城路刚刚发生了一起2名寄养家庭的小孩坠楼的意外，目前已经送到了亚东医院来急救。立刻透过现场连线，请记者秦林谦来告诉我们。
This minute, Japan still handed China their loss with 3 goals, which included a debatable volleyball-like spike from Koji Nakata.
Japan had their first chance in front of the net at 22 minutes when they got a free kick opportunity after Wei Xin was judged for a foul. Midfield Takashi Fukunishi received the pass from Akira Kaji and headed it into the net at close range. China's real chance came at 30-minute point when Yan Song brought the ball from the left side all the way down to the bottom and Li Ming followed up with a push to score.The first half ended with a 1-1 tie. At 63 minutes into the second half, Japan's corner kick trolled towards the front of the net into a confusion of offense and defense onto the arm of Japan's Koji Makata and finally into the net. The referee judged it to be an effective goal for Japan. China,possibly affected by the judgment, became noticeably sloppy for the rest of the time and watched helplessly at the 92nd minute as the ball went into their net under the foot of Keiji Tamada of Japan. Again, for the third time, Japan has climbed to the top of Asian football.